So there are many different ways we could define add to index. Here's one way that works. So we're going to create a procedure. We'll call it add to index, and it takes our three inputs, the index, the keyword, and the URL. What we need to do in add to index is first find if the keyword already appears. So to do that, we need to look through all the entries in index. The natural way to do that is to use a for loop. So we're going to define the procedure, add to index, and it takes our three inputs, index, keyword, and URL. To help keep track of what we're doing, I'm going to draw a reminder of what the data structure of index is. Remember that it's a list of entries, and each entry is itself a list, where the first part is the keyword, and the second part is a list of the URLs. So that's our data structure. That's going to help us figure out what to do to define add to index. So the first thing we need to do is to check whether the keyword already exists in the index. If we can find it, well, then we want to modify that entry rather than creating a new one. So the natural way to do that is to use a for loop. So we're going to loop through the elements of index. We'll give each one the name entry to use in the block. So this is what entry will be. So the first time through the loop, the value of entry will be a reference to the list here, which is the first element of the index list. So now we need to find the keyword. So the keyword is right here. That's the element at position 0 of entry. So we're going to test, is the value at position 0 in entry identical to the keyword that's passed in? We'll use the double equal comparison to test that. If it is equal, well, we found a match. This means we want to append the URL to the list of URLs associated with that entry. So to get that list of URLs, we want to find entry 1. That's the value at position 1 of entry. And we want to append to that the new URL. So here we've found an entry that matches the keyword we were looking for. This means the keyword is already in the index. We've added the new URL to the list of URLs associated with that keyword. And so we're done. We have nothing else to do. What we want to make sure is that we don't continue and do anything else. One approach would be to use break. That would end the loop. What we want to do instead is really end the whole procedure. If we did break, well, then we still have the problem of how do we deal with a case where the keyword wasn't found. So here we're just going to return. We're all done with add to index. We've added the URL where it belongs. Now we need to think about what to do in the case where the keyword does not already exist in the index. If that's the case, then we get to the end of the loop without ever finding that entry. So if we got to the end of the loop, that means we did not find any entry in the index that matches the keyword. Then what we want to do is add a new entry. And that new entry is going to have as its value a list containing two elements. It'll be the keyword. And as the second element, we'll have a list containing the URLs that we found that have that keyword. So far, we only have one, the URL that was passed in to add to index. So how do we do that? Well, to add a new element to index, we use append. And we need something to pass into append that's the structure that we want to add. This whole thing is what we want to add. So that's a list containing the value keyword as its first element. As the second element, it's a list containing just the single URL. So that's what we want to append in the case where we didn't find the keyword already in the index.